Happy Saturday, everybody. Sports Guy Chris checking back in with you. I am super excited, super pumped up for today because, of course, today I unveil my official bracket to you all out there. As if, you know, Selection Sunday, we're still progressing as normal, as regularly scheduled for tomorrow. So today I've got my official 2020 March Madness NCAA Tournament bracket ready for you all. Before I unveil that in just a few moments here, a couple of notes on the bracket and how I put the field together. So, first of all, any conference tournaments that finished up and had awarded their automatic bid to the conference tournament champion, those teams are in the field representing those respective conferences. For those conferences that weren't able to finish up their conference tournaments, the regular season conference champion got the automatic bid and is represented in the field. So in those instances, those teams also would have been the number one seed in that respective conference's tournament. So that is how I went about that. As far as evaluating the bubble, the last four teams in, and so forth, I went with where I was at before any of the bubble teams actually played in conference tournament games. So a couple of bubble teams that were at the end, you know, of the field there, they did have an opportunity to play between like Tuesday and Wednesday, and then a whole bunch of other bubble teams did not. So the way I went about that is basically treated those tournament games that the bubble teams did play, kind of, you know, not counting them. Don't want to count or, you know, favor those in when other bubble teams didn't have an opportunity to play. So what I went with is where those teams were at before any of them had the opportunity to play in their conference tournament. So no changes, no last minute switch arounds or anything like that. This is exactly how I saw the bubble, you know, Monday or Tuesday of last week. So with that being said, the field is set. We're going to start in the Midwest region where the top overall seed resides. So we're going to jump right into it. Going to go region by region here for you guys. And we're going to start in the Midwest region. So the Midwest bracket, of course, starts with the top overall seed in the tournament, and that is the Kansas Jayhawks. The Big 12 regular season champion, the Jayhawks, of course, have been on fire. Haven't lost a game since early January when they lost at home to Baylor. So Kansas comes in at 28-3. They are the top overall seed and the number one seed in the Midwest region. They will play the winner of Siena, went 20-10, and North Carolina Central, one of the two, you know, 16 seed play-in games. So the Jayhawks will get the winner of that one. Then moving along, the 8 seed in the Midwest region, the LSU Tigers out of the SEC. LSU went 21-10 on the regular season. They will be squaring off against the 9 seed out of the Big Ten, the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, who went 20-11. Congratulations to Rutgers. They are in the tournament. They had been a cellar dweller ever since joining the Big Ten. They broke out this year and are back in the NCAA tournament. Moving along, the 5 seed, the BYU Cougars out of the West Coast Conference. BYU went 24-8, receiving an at-large bid out of the West Coast. They had a sparkling net rating of 9 when conference tournaments were postponed there a little bit earlier in the week. So BYU, solid metrics. They are the 5 seed in the Midwest. They will play the winner of one of the play-in games, first 4, last 4 in, between 12 seed Cincinnati, who went 20-10. They were a co-champion of the American Athletic Conference, and NC State, the Wolfpack of NC State, the last team in the field. They went 20-12, and the winner will play the BYU Cougars. So that is the first of the play-in games. Moving along, the 4 seed in the Midwest, the Wisconsin Badgers. Co-Big Ten champions, of course. Wisconsin rolled down the stretch, won their last 8 to get a piece of the Big Ten title. And they were the number one seed in the Big Ten tournament had the tournament went on as originally scheduled. So Wisconsin in as the 4 seed, excuse me. They will be playing the 13 seed Northern Kentucky out of the Horizon League. Northern Kentucky won the Horizon. They went 23-9. They were second place in the regular season to Wright State, but they were able to win the conference tournament. So Northern Kentucky in as the 13. Moving along, the sixth seed, the Arizona Wildcats, 21-11 out of the Pac-12. They will be playing the 11 seed Richmond Spiders out of the Atlantic 10 Conference. Richmond went 24-7. One of their noteworthy victories was a 10-point win early in the season over Wisconsin. So congratulations to the Spiders. They are in the field as the 11. Moving along, the number 3 seed in the Midwest, Big East co-champion, the Seton Hall Pirates. Seton Hall finished up the regular season 21-9. A very, very solid resume. They were co-champions of the Big East. Very difficult conference. Big East rated as the second most difficult behind the Big Ten. So they will be playing the Akron Zips. Akron, the top team out of the MAC. The Zips went 24-7 and will match up with the Pirates. Moving along to the bottom of the Midwest region, the number 7 seed, Iowa Hawkeyes out of the Big Ten. Iowa went 20-11. We have a great matchup as they will be taking on the 10 seed out of the Big East, the Marquette Golden Eagles. So Marquette gets in a little bit of a skid. They lost their last three coming in down the stretch, but the Golden Eagles in the field as the 10 seed in the Midwest, taking on Iowa. Rounding out the Midwest region, we have the 2 seed Florida State Seminoles, the Atlantic Coast Conference champions, 26-5. And they will be playing North Texas. North Texas, the Conference USA regular season champion, they went 20-11. So that is the Midwest region. Moving along, we go to the what would be below the Midwest if you're looking at the bracket, and that would be the East region. And the number 1 seed in the East, the Baylor Bears out of the Big 12. Baylor went 26-4, of course. Lost a couple down the stretch, still had a really good season. Of course, the big win on the resume was the win at Kansas early in January. So Baylor is the final number 1 seed in the field and the 1 seed in the East region. They will be taking on UC Irvine, the Anteaters from the Big West Conference. So the UC Irvine in as the 16 seed, taking on Baylor. Moving along, the 8 seed, the St. Mary's Gales. They went 25-8. St. Mary's, the second team in the field out of the West Coast Conference. Of course, St. Mary's also had some pretty good non-conference victories on their resume, including one over Wisconsin. So St. Mary's in as the 8 seed in the East. And they will take on the number 9 seed out of the Big 12, the Texas Tech Red Raiders. Texas Tech comes in with a sparkling net of 22. They did drop their last three in the regular season. None of them, though, could be considered a bad loss, all the tournament teams. So Texas Tech in as the 9 seed in the East. Moving along, the number 5 seed, the Butler Bulldogs. Butler in out of the Big East. They went 22-9, and they will be taking on the number 12 seed, the Yale Bulldogs. So Battle of the Bulldogs in the 5-12 matchup in the East. Yale went 23-6 and won the Ivy League regular season. Moving along, the 4 seed in the East, the Louisville Cardinals out of the ACC. Louisville went 24-7 on the regular season, and they finished a game behind Florida State, tied with Duke and Virginia for second in the ACC. They will be taking on the 13 seed, Vermont Catamounts. Vermont, 25-7, another solid season for the Catamounts. It seems like year in and year out, Vermont seems to win their conference there. They are in once again this year as the 13 seed in the East. Moving along, the 6 seed, the Auburn Tigers out of the SEC. Auburn went 25-6. All 6 of their losses came within conference play. They went unbeaten in their non-conference. And they will be taking on the 11 seed out of the Pac-12, the Arizona State Sun Devils. Arizona State went 20-11. That should be a heck of a 6-11 matchup here in the East region. So down below them, the 3 seed in the East, the SEC regular season champion, Kentucky Wildcats. Kentucky comes in pretty hot. They finished the season you know, on a pretty good winning streak. They come in 25-6, including a big rally in their last game, a win at Florida, won the SEC regular season, and they will be taking on Hofstra. Hofstra, the pride in as the number 14 seed in the East. Hofstra went 26-8, won their conference tournament, and are in the field. So now to the bottom of the East region, the 7 seed, the Houston Cougars, taking on the 10 seed out of the Big 12, the Oklahoma Sooners. So an excellent matchup there as well in another 7-10 game between Houston and Oklahoma. And now rounding out the East region, the number 2 seed, Duke Blue Devils out of the ACC. Duke went 25-6, finished tied for second, a game behind Florida State in league play. And they will be taking on, out of the Summit League, the North Dakota State Bison. North Dakota State won the Summit. They come in with a record of 24-8, regular season and conference tournament champions. So that rounds out the left side of the bracket and the East region. So moving along now to the upper right of the bracket, and we've got the West region. Starting at the top with the number 1 seed in the West, Gonzaga. The Gonzaga Bulldogs, of course, went ahead and won the West Coast Conference, and they were able to defeat St. Mary's in the West Coast Conference tournament to win the tournament as well. So Gonzaga comes in. They are the number 2 of the 1 seeds, if you will, and the 1 seed in the West region after going 31-2. They will play the winner of the other 16-seed play-in game between Prairie View and Robert Morris. Prairie View went 19-13, Robert Morris 20-14. So the winner of that game will take on the Zags. Moving along, the 8 seed in the West out of the Pac-12, Colorado. Colorado Buffaloes went 21-11. They stumbled a little bit down the stretch. Still really good metrics for their, you know, the Buffaloes, and they are in as the 8 seed. Great matchup here as they will take on the 9 seed out of the SEC, the Florida Gators. Florida went 19-12. Another solid season for the Gators, and what should be a heck of an 8-9 matchup in the West. The 5 seed in the West region out of the Big Ten, the Ohio State Buckeyes. The Buckeyes went 21-10. Another fine season, a great, great non-conference slate for the Buckeyes. Struggled at the beginning of Big Ten play, got hot down the stretch. They are in as the 5 seed, and they will take on the number 12 seed, Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks. The Lumberjacks went 28-3 in the regular season. What should be a heck of a matchup here in a 5-12 game as Ohio State takes on Stephen F. Austin. So moving along, the 4 seed in the West, Oregon Ducks. Oregon, of course, won the Pac-12 regular season title and were the 1 seed going into the Pac-12 tournament. They will take on the 13 seed, New Mexico State Aggies. New Mexico State won the WAC, Western Athletic Conference, with a record of 25-6. And again, were the 1 seed for their conference tournament as well. So Oregon and New Mexico State in the 4-13 matchup. Moving on to the bottom half of that region, the number 6 seed out of the Big Ten, the Illinois Fighting Illini, 21-10. A nice season for the Illini. They had a whole plethora of quality victories, including a win at Wisconsin, a place they hadn't won at in a very long time. So Illinois into the field. They will take on the 11 seed Liberty Flames. Liberty, 30-4, regular season and conference tournament champions out of their league. That should be a heck of a 6-11 matchup. Liberty, of course, very, very solid metrics. Might have had a chance to get in at it as an at-large, but not needed here as they won both their regular season conference tournaments. Moving along to the 3 seed, the Villanova Wildcats. Villanova, co-Big East champions, along with Seton Hall and Creighton. They are the 3 seed, 24-7 in the regular season. They will be taking on Boston University. Boston won their conference tournament, taking out in the Patriot League conference tournament. They took out Bucknell in the title game there. Boston in, 21-13 record, and they are in as the 14 seed. Now rounding out the West region, The 7 seed out of the Big Ten, Penn State, Nittany Lions. Penn State 21-10. They had been on fire earlier in the season, stumbled a little bit down the stretch, cooled off after a big hot streak. They were actually 18-5 at one point in time. So Penn State cooled a little bit, still in as the 7 seed, and they draw the number 10 seed, East Tennessee State Buccaneers. East Tennessee State, another team that probably had a good chance to get in as an at-large had they not won their conference tournament. They won both the regular season and conference tournament for their league. So East Tennessee State Buccaneers in as the 10 seed, 30-4 record, what should be a good matchup there with the Nittany Lions. And rounding out the West region, the number 2 seed out of the Mountain West Conference, the San Diego State Aztecs. San Diego State, of course, finishes up 30-2. They had a long unbeaten streak, started the season 25-0. They are the 2 seed, and they will be going against Little Rock, the 15 seed Little Rock. Little Rock went 21-10, won their conference in the regular season. So that rounds out the West region, which now brings us to the lower right of the bracket and the final region in the field. So in the South region, we start things off at the top with the 1 seed, the Dayton Flyers out of the Atlantic 10 Conference. Dayton went 29-2 in the regular season and were a perfect unbeaten 18-0 in their league in A10 play. So the Flyers come in as the number 1 seed in the South region. They will be taking on Eastern Washington. Eastern Washington went 23-8 to win their league. And they will take on the winner, of course, of the 8-9 matchup. The 8 seed in the South, the Providence College Friars, PC in, after going 19-12. They were one of the hottest teams in the country, of course, to finish up the regular season. PC in as the 8 seed in the South. They finished up 19-12, and they will take on, out of the Pac-12, the number 9 seed, USC Trojans. USC 22-9, taking on the Friars in what should be a great 8-9 matchup. So, moving along in the South region, the number 5 seed, out of the Big 12 Conference, the West Virginia Mountaineers. West Virginia 21-10. During the regular season. Again, a hot start for them. Struggled a little bit within conference play, within a very, pretty difficult Big 12. But nonetheless, West Virginia, very, very solid metrics. Top 20 net ranking, top 20 strength of schedule. So they're in as the 5. And then the final play-in game between the 12 seed Indiana at 20-12 and the 12 seed Xavier, 19-13, Xavier in, out of the Big East. So Indiana and Xavier rounding out the other two of the last 4 in teams, and they are playing in the play-in game as the 12 seeds in the South region. So moving along, number 4 seed and co-Big Ten regular season champions, the Maryland Terrapins. Maryland finished up 24-7. They are in as the number 4 seed, and they will take on the Belmont Bruins. Belmont in the tournament again for the 2nd consecutive year. Belmont, 26-7, regular season and conference tournament champion. Should be a heck of a 4-13 matchup there. And then moving along to the number 6 seed in the South, the Virginia Cavaliers, defending national champion. The Cavaliers started the season a bit slow, came on strong, and got all the way to 15-5 in ACC play, tied for 2nd with Louisville and Duke. They went 23-7 overall. So the defending champs back in as a 6 seed in the South. They will be taking on the number 11 seed out of the Pac-12, UCLA Bruins. UCLA 19-12, finished a game behind Oregon in the Pac-12, and really strung together some impressive victories within league play down the stretch. That should be a heck of a 6-11 matchup right there in the South region. So now rounding out the South and the final region of the bracket, the number 3 seed, Creighton Blue Jays, co-Big East champions along with Villanova and Seton Hall. Creighton in as the 3 seed, and they will take on the number 14 seed, Bradley. Bradley, conference tournament champions, 23-11 out of the Missouri Valley Conference. So Bradley in, taking on Creighton. Moving along to the 7 seed Out of the Big Ten, Michigan Wolverines. Michigan 19-12 overall on the season. And they will be taking on the Mountain West Conference Tournament champion, Utah State Aggies. Utah State in as the number 10 seed. Utah State finished up the regular season, finished up the season rather with a record of 26-8. They were second to San Diego State during the regular season in the Mountain West, and they were able to scrape past the Aztecs in the Mountain West Conference Tournament title game to punch their ticket. Rounding out the field, the number 2 seed in the South, the Michigan State Spartans, co-Big Ten champion, sparkling metrics. They finished up with the number 1 strength of schedule, number 7 net rating, Michigan State, the 2 seed, and they will take on Winthrop. Winthrop, of course, the winner of out of the Big South. Winthrop, the number 15 seed, they went 24-10, rounding out the field. So there you have it, everybody. The At Sports Guy Chris 2020 March Madness bracket. I will be back, of course, to simulate every game going through. I would highly encourage all of your, you know, thoughts, comments, and everything. I will be having prizes for the correct picks and best brackets and so on and so forth. In the meantime, I would love to get your thoughts down in the comment section about what you thought of the official bracket. Be sure to check out my post. If you like today's video, the bracket unveil, please give me a thumbs up down there. Don't forget to subscribe and follow. You can find me on Instagram and Scorem at SportsGuyChris. Again, keeping March Madness alive in my own little way, my official bracket reveal. I will be back again with another video, and I will start the simulations of the games with the play-in games, the 2-16 seed play-in games and the 2-12 seed play-in games. We'll get that filled out, and then we'll have an official 64-team bracket set. I will be simulating those games on Monday. So as the tournament, in lieu of the tournaments, I'm still keeping March Madness alive. I'm going to simulate it, take it all the way right down to the end, guys. Final Four and national champion. We're going to crown one. Stay tuned for more. And again, Sports Guy Chris, my official 2020 March Madness bracket unveil. Thank you all for your support. Everybody, stay strong out there. And again, I'll be back soon. Keeping March Madness alive. Happy Saturday, everybody.